Hi, welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Josh from OnScale. Hi, Josh, welcome to the show.
Hi, Andrea.
So what do you guys do?
OnScale is a computer-aided engineering firm, and we provide access to high-performance computing resources in the cloud.
Excellent. So today we're going to talk about cloud HPC orchestration.
Correct.
So walk us through that. What is that?
Sure. So when an engineer wants to run a simulation of a product before they manufacture a prototype, they perform a series of regular simulations of a type that have been going on for quite some time. But these have been limited to firms that have access to large on-prem data centers. With AWS, all firms can have access to that, and that's what OnScale provides.
Wonderful. So it's running on AWS, as you mentioned, and I see a number of different AWS services here on the board. So let's look at one event.
Sure.
I'm an engineer. I have a simulation. I want to submit. What is the first thing that happens?
Well, the first thing that happens is the customer will send data to an S3 bucket. They'll encrypt those data with a KMS key and send it here, and then they will schedule their job to run. That scheduled job gets sent off to EKS to spin up a right-sized HPC node right here.
I see. So you have a Kubernetes cluster, obviously for orchestration, and the HPC nodes. Walk me through that. Like, how do you right-size? What instances do you use?
Sure. So the customer will tell us how much memory they require, or our estimators will, and then how many cores they need, and how many different simulations they want to run. They may run one job that's got 2,000 cores, or 2,000 jobs that have two cores each, something like that.
I see.
So depending on what they require, we'll spin up the appropriate resources for them.
I see.
That takes, you know, between 3 to 5 minutes, right? But since it can go from zero to hero instantly almost, our big concern is how do we orchestrate all of the services so that they don't blow up?
Exactly.
And for that, the real secret sauce of ours is we send all of the data that's streaming out of our HPC nodes to a CloudWatch log, which can handle huge amounts of traffic.
Okay.
And it has alerts cooked into it that fires off data that matches certain patterns to the appropriate lambdas for doing data processing.
Okay.
So CloudWatch will start a Lambda run to, say, alert to progress or tell the customer that there's a preliminary result available so that they can look at, see if the simulation is right or not, cancel or continue.
I see.
And then those Lambdas will fire off SNS messages to queue yet more Lambdas.
I see.
To do other things like write data to DynamoDB, send messages to Redis for handling things like WebSockets to keep the customer informed about what's happening.
See.
So the HPC nodes themselves connect to S3, but that's the only service they connect to other than Lambda to get a license and a key for S3. After that, everything goes through CloudWatch and then through Lambda to handle the spikes on traffic, which going from zero to 10,000 simulations in a minute causes.
So you use Lambdas. This is a very clever way to handle sort of the spiky workloads, also limitations. So walk us through a scenario. I mean, I see DynamoDB, right? Walk us through a situation there where, you know, DynamoDB would be triggered by Lambda.
So a simulation starts. Mm-hmm. It's going to send a message to CloudWatch that says, simulation running. At that point, a Lambda will write database matches with a UUID that describes the simulation and a date that says it started at this time. And then, likewise, when it's over, it'll say finished, and we'll write another row here.
I see.
Then, not surprisingly, we'll subtract the end time from the start time, and that's how long the simulation ran.
Does the engineer then get any reporting, any insights into status?
Absolutely.
How is that facilitated?
I mean, that's the beauty of using CloudWatch and Lambda, is that we can get out of these sequestered nodes, which we keep well off the internet, right? And the data is proxied through CloudWatch and Lambda so that the information that the customer desires, which is, you know, is it going? You know, are we progressing? Do we have, can I see a picture of what's happening? How's the signal? Is it ringing down like I expect or not? And then finally, when it's over, they'll find out and they'll go to S3 and pull down the results.
Okay, so the simulation completes. Then the output is back on S3?
Correct. The HPC node will deliver the results back into the same bucket with the using the same key that the customer already has.
Very interesting.
So it never goes to S3 until it's encrypted again with the key that they downloaded to start the whole process.
I see. That's fantastic. And walk us through sort of the scale. I suspect there's many simultaneous simulations happening.
Sure, exactly.
How do you handle that?
Yeah, the customer can start one simulation, which is how they're used to doing it. Mm-hmm. But at OnScale, they can do parametric computer-aided engineering, which is, you know, similar to parametric CAD, which they're all familiar with through innovations like SolidWorks. But parametric computer-aided engineering, they can do 10,000 simulations at the same time and pick out just the right combination of lengths and sizes and materials in order to get the perfect product.
Wonderful. This is a very interesting architecture you walked us through here, you know, using obviously your cloud HPC orchestration and leveraging Lambdas to handle limitations and other sort of spiky workloads that that's coming in from the engineers. So thanks again for walking us through this architecture. And thank you for watching. This is my architecture.